right, last lesson I showed the two main chord forms that you need to play the song, Lenny. And I looked at the way that those two chords connect in the main sequence with this little riff. Alright, now, when Stevie gets done and he plays through that like four times, he moves into this. He's taking the second chord form that we looked at from last time, this little shape right here. And you can go back to the last lesson to review how that chord is actually formed. So it's kind of like a little dance. So now let's look at the notes that I'm picking when I do this. When I do this, I start on the low E, and then I play the top two notes of this chord. Then I slide and play the same top two notes. And then when I slide into this chord, I play all the notes in sequence. Again, I go. He slides it up to the 10th fret. Slides it back down to the 3rd fret. You can see he's not changing the chord at all. The tricky part is learning how to arpeggiate those chords and slide them together. But what I'm going to do is I'm just going to play that sequence really, really slow so that you can hear the individual notes that I'm playing in each of those chords. And then until it becomes second nature, you can just try and duplicate those exact chords. And play that section over again if you need to, but those are the chords that I use when I arpeggiate, when I'm sliding those chords around, and that's as close as I can tell what Stevie's playing there. Now he may play them slightly different from time to time. I have a feeling that it wasn't something that he set in stone, but when he gets to the end there, then he would do this riff. Just like how he would connect the chords of the first lesson, except that he would just stop right here. So he'd follow it up with a low E and a harmonic on the 12th fret, and then he would flip his pickup down to the neck pick or to the bridge pickup and follow up with a harmonic up by the bridge pickup. Which is like the 24th fret. So it was. So he would use those harmonics as a substitute for this chord. So you can see that second part is not complicated. That whole sequence isn't hard because he keeps the chord form the same. You just need to learn to arpeggiate those chords in a way that flows together. And when you get to the end, just pull one of these. And you're right back into the sequence that we learned in the first lesson. All right, have some fun with that.